Hi, this is Trey from Switzerland with another knife review. Today we're going to take a look at a knife from a company that was new to me. I learned about them 1 or 2 months ago and was immediately intrigued by their high-end knife designs, which they did with some well-known custom knife makers and also some very interesting in-house designs. And one of these in-house designs we're going to take a look at today, and the knife is called the LTC Nomad by Three Rivers Manufacturing, as you can see here down in the corner. This is the company that manufactures these knives. And Three Rivers Manufacturing is actually a subdivision of Halpern Titanium Incorporated, which is a very well-known manufacturer for high-end knife companies that does a lot of machining, CNC, water jet, and all that kinds of things. And so they really know how to machine parts for high-end knives. And here is one of their own designs. This is an in-house design by Three Rivers Manufacturing. They also did some collaborations with some custom makers. I'm going to inlay a couple of pictures of their other models that they have in their lineup. But this knife is a very special one because it was designed to be legal in a lot of places around the world. And that is also why it's a quite small knife. And also that is why it doesn't sport a lock, but a very, very interesting slip joint mechanism that we're going to talk about later in the video. Now let's take a look at the specs of the Three Rivers Manufacturing LTC Nomad. So you have an overall length of 5.5 inches or about 14 centimeters. That gives you a blade length of 2 1/8 inches or 5.4 centimeters with a cutting edge of about 2 inches and a handle length of 3.5 inches or about 9 centimeters. You also get a pretty stout blade thickness of 3 millimeters or 0.12 inches, and the blade is made out of CPM 154 steel, so a very nice high-end steel, which is hardened to about 57 to 59 Rockwell. Now let's take a look at the weight of the Three Rivers Manufacturing LTC Nomad, which actually stands for legal to carry, so that is really the main focus of the design of this knife. And you can see here the knife weighs 73 grams or about 2.6 ounces, which is a pretty lightweight. And also it really feels even lighter in hand. It's a really nice ergonomic design, and really you don't feel the LTC Nomad in your pocket as you're carrying it. So really well done here by Three Rivers Manufacturing. Now let's take a closer look at the 2 1/8 inch long CPM 154 steel blade of the LTC Nomad, and you can see here a very nice and aggressive stubby blade shape. It's a drop point design with a high flat grind and also a nice finger choil here on the blade, which gives you additional safety when you're using it, because of course it is a slip joint knife, so you don't have a lock. But if you have your finger choil under here like on a Spyderco, you are very safe when using the knife. Here you also can see the really nicely done Three Rivers Manufacturing logo, really, really classy, and the absolutely gorgeous and well-executed stonewash finish here on this blade. You also have your opening hole here at the top, which needs a little bit of training until you can get the knife open easily with the smaller thumb hole right here. But I also think the knife was mainly designed to be a two-hand opening knife, so it is legal in even more places than a one-handed opening knife would be. The knife came extremely razor sharp out of the box. Was really, really impressed with that. And that is, of course, also a nice benefit from the steel choice, because here you have CPM 154 and not 154 CM. So it's a powder metallurgy steel. And that means it has some features that are quite a lot better than on the 154 CM. And this is mainly the grain structure, so it's easier to get a very, very fine edge here on this CPM 154, and also the toughness of the steel is improved by the powder metallurgy technology that they apply to the well-known American 154 CM steel. So really nice steel choice, really nice high-end steel, also because you don't see that much high-end steels used in slip joint style knife. So if you want to get a really high-end slip joint with a high-end steel, this one would certainly be a very good option for you. Now let's take a look at the nicely and ergonomically designed handle of the Nomad. You can see here mine has a OD Green G10 handle scale. There are a lot of different colors available. There is orange, there is of course black, blue, also a Digicam version and a carbon fiber version available of the LTC Nomad. And under the nicely textured G10 scales is a really high quality G10 that is very, very grippy. It's one of the most grippy G10s that I have in my collection personally. And under there we have a two titanium liners, as you can see here, and they are jimped all the way. The blade has no jimping, unfortunately, but the titanium liners are jimped the whole back of the knife right here, and are also quite thick titanium liners. And they also incorporate the slip joint mechanism, which I'm going to show you later. You also have a very, very nice deep carry titanium pocket clip, which also is finished in this gorgeous stonewashed finish that they have applied to the titanium frame and also the blade, as you have seen before. But this clip is near complete perfection. It rides very, very low in your pocket. It is strong enough to keep the knife in your pocket, but not so strong that you rip up your pockets by the very textured G10 scales. It also is a flow-through design, as you can see here, which makes the knife even lighter than if they put in a backspacer right here. And they use also very interesting hardware, in my opinion. You can see here they have these big pivot screws, one in the back, which attaches the pocket clip, and one in the front, which actually is your pivot screw, and then the two small screws to attach your scale. The handle design is also very, very ergonomic, together with the forward finger trial that is here on the blade. The knife is really extremely nice in hand, really feels absolutely comfortable. You have absolutely no hot spots, not from the clip, not from anything. They really designed this knife to fit your hand perfectly with this nice finger trial right here. So really, really nice and ergonomic overall design. And you also have an additional safety feature by the forward trial, because if you close the blade accidentally, you are not going to cut your finger because you have your forward finger trial there on the blade. Another nice thing about the handle construction on the LTC Nomad is that you can take off the G10 scales very, very easily without loosening the pivot screw or the back screw. So really, really easy to do. You just loosen the two body screws, two scale screws like this, and then you can just lift up your G10 scale like that. So very, very easy to change out the G10 scales. I'm not quite sure if you can actually order the different color G10 scales separately from Three Rivers Manufacturing, but I think that would be a really, really cool thing, that you can change out the look of your Nomad that easily and without loosening the pivot screw and changing up the centering of your blade. But I took the scales off for another reason actually, and that is to show you the very, very interesting slip joint mechanism that they have built here into the titanium frame of the Nomad. You can see here the frame is also finished in this very nice stone wash that they did all around the blade, and you can see here that the back spring is actually milled out of the titanium frame, so you don't have an actual separate back spring or anything like that that you would have on a normal slip joint style folder. But this reminds me a lot of the mechanism used in the Spyderco Pits folder, and I think that is really interesting that you can see how this mechanism actually works. I'm going to try to demonstrate that to you. So if you open the knife, it lifts up the milled out part of the titanium frame right here. Try to keep it in focus. And then it falls down into the notch in the blade to give it a little bit of traction, so you cannot close it too easily. And the spring part that is milled out of the titanium frame is now flush at the top right here with the rest of the frame. So really, really nice, interesting slip joint mechanism, in my opinion. Very, very well done here by Three Rivers Manufacturing. I really like these innovative lock designs. Maybe you can also take a peek inside the pivot area here. You can see they have bronze washers here on the inside. So really nice high-end pivot as well. And if you close it, the titanium spring part also falls back into a notch in the blade and secures the blade in the closed position that way. So really interesting slip joint mechanism here on the LTC Nomad by Three Rivers Manufacturing. Now let's take a look at fit and finish and the action of the LTC Nomad. You can see here that the centering of this knife is absolutely flawless, perfectly dead center, very well done. And you also can see that the grinding on the blade itself is very symmetrical. So a really high-end grinding job that they did here as well. And you can see here everything fits together just perfectly. Everything is lined up in the right place. Here you can see also the polishing that they did here on the back part of the blade where it contacts with the titanium frame. You also can see here that the blade actually wraps around the stop pin, so that is how it secures the knife in the closed position. And also the action is very smooth, especially for a slip joint knife. Really nice action, and you can see you can open it easily with two hands by using the thumb hole that way, but with a little bit of practice you also can use just the thumb hole here to rotate it out of the handle without any problem. And it's also quite a fun slip joint to play with once you get a hang of the one hand opening on the Nomad right here. So really nice action, really smooth, really defined action, and also a pretty cool and well executed detent. You can see here it sucks the blade in from pretty high up, right here. So really nice. You can also take a look at the milling that they did here on the cutout here for your finger. Very nicely done. There are absolutely no sharp corners or anything like that on this blade. All of the edges here are chamfered. You have the nice texturing here on the spine of the blade, which provides a little bit of additional traction to the very tractionable G10 handles right here. I also love the big screws for the pocket clip and the pivot. Gives the knife a really nice look. So overall, fit and finish and action on these knives are very excellent. I have nothing to complain in that department here. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of the LTC Nomad. I now had this knife for about a month and carried it a good 2 weeks of that time, mostly to go to work and do some light cutting tasks like opening ledgers, boxes, cutting up some strands of my clothing and stuff like that. And it performed very well in that department. And now let's see how sharp it is after that use. And it also came razor sharp. It could easily shave hair off my arm without any problem right out of the box. And it still has a very nice sharpness and slices completely effortlessly through this paper right here. You can see absolutely no problem to cut the paper. And just a breeze to cut up here these paper pieces. So absolutely no problem. Really nice edge retention here after 1 month of use and carry. Now let's come to the size comparison I like to do to get you a feel for the overall size of the knife to a knife that you already may own. And now the first comparison I have for you is a very inexpensive knife but has a little bit of similar lines to the LTC Nomad, and it is the Kershaw Shuffle. A very nice little multi-tool knife with some additional tools. And size-wise and also in the blade profile, it has some similarities to the LTC Nomad, but of course the materials are much lower grade than the ones used here on the LTC Nomad. But you can see size-wise these two knives are very similar overall. Both of them are extremely ergonomic in hand, and I think these two are a very good comparison to each other. So if you have a shuffle, the LTC Nomad is about the same size. The next comparison I have for you would be a knife from Boker Plus. It is the Panatella, which I have previously reviewed. It's also a very nice gentleman's folder, button lock, 440C steel blade. Size wise, also very, very similar, maybe a tiny, tiny bit longer at the tip of the blade right here. And it also has titanium handles with a carbon fiber inlay here in the middle. And it's a very nice and fun little EDC carry folder here. You also can see a comparison in the thickness department right there. Both of them are very nice, lightweight, easy to carry knives, but I would think the LTC Nomad is a little bit more heavy duty and can handle a little bit more harder use tasks than the Panatella can. So the next comparison I have for you is a Spyderco, maybe the best comparison in terms of overall similarities that I have for you, and it is the Spidey K from Spyderco. This is a orange version. This is of course also a slip joint knife, also a very lightweight blade, has also a very deep carry pocket clip, the wire pocket clip from Spyderco, also a quite high-end steel with the N690 CO, and is made in Italy. And you can see the Spy DK is a slight bit longer overall, also has the finger choil here to make to secure your finger a little bit better if the knife is going to close. So this is a very good comparison in the overall similarities, I think, but the materials used in the Nomad are of course one or two steps above the ones used here in the Spy DK. And a last comparison I have for you is a case knife. It is the Case Mini Copperhead in the Blue Lagoon Jigged Bone pattern. And size-wise, these are also quite close, but of course they are quite different knives, but I thought you maybe have a case knife at home and so you have a good comparison to the overall size of the LTC Nomad. I really like my case knife, but of course it's a more traditional, more lightly used knife than your Nomad would be, but I really like the overall aesthetics of this case knife very much. I really like the Blue Lagoon series of the jig bone pattern right here. So really cool, little, easy to carry and very people friendly knife here with the case, but size wise very similar to the LTC Nomad by Three Rivers Manufacturing. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about this knife. So if you want to get yourself your own LTC Nomad by Three Rivers Manufacturing, you're gonna pay around $225. That is a quite high price, but I think you get a lot of really interesting features with your LTC Nomad and a very interesting overall design and some features that you don't get in a slip joint knife normally. You get a very, very high-end steel with your CPM 154. You get all titanium frame and your choice of G10 or a carbon fiber handle scales. Really nice overall construction, extremely ergonomic overall design. Very, very handsome overall aesthetics. The aesthetics of this knife really, really connect with me. It's a really cool, stubby, stout overall design. Some nice features and a complete perfect pocket clip, which has absolutely nothing to complain about. Also, the finishing of the clip and the blade and everything makes this a really durable knife and a knife that you are not scared to use because you could scratch it up, because this finish is really nice in masking some scratches and still looks extremely nice overall. So it is of course 100% made in the US out of premium materials, and if you're searching for a high-end slip joint, because only slip joints are legal to carry in that place where you live, I would strongly recommend to take a good look at the Nomad by Three Rivers Manufacturing. You really get a top-notch slip joint knife here with a lot of features that you normally see in high-end locking knives from big American companies, and you really get very, very cool aesthetics overall, and they're very, very nicely built high-end slip joint in my opinion. I really like this knife. I'm not that big of a slip joint guy personally, but this knife really connected with me with its overall aesthetics, its extremely good ergonomics and its high-end materials. I really could not pass it up and really like it and carried it a lot more than I had anticipated. So that was my review of the LTC Nomad by Three Rivers Manufacturing. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions about anything I talked about in this video, about the knife, about all the size comparison knives or anything like that, please leave it in the comments. I will try to answer you there. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.